It's time for The Match Game, Hollywood Square, Power, with From Another World, Mary Page Keller. From Happy Days, Anson Williams. And the stars of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour, Gene Rayburn and John Bauman.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Yeah, that's right.
What do you want to do today?
Well, I don't know. What do you want to do, Marty?
I don't know. What do you want to do?
What do you say
Let's
we do?
Let's go hang out in the
Match
corner.
Game Hollywood Square. Should we do that? Okay. You know, would you join John and me in saying hello to our stars? Hello, stars.
Hi, stars. Hello. Well, if Marty thought of that, he probably wouldn't want me to do it.
That's right.
I could have bailed him out. Those
have
guys
a seat here, John, and join the group here. Wonderful to see you again, dear friends and gentle hearts. Mark, is everything under control with you?
What if I just came back from Washington? They're going to pass a bill there to get all of the criminals off the street and back into Congress where they belong.
Those of you who live permanently in Los Angeles and have never been to Washington, Mark Russell has been known for a good many years here as a satirist, a singer, a songwriter. And he's played at a gin mill in Washington. What's the name of the place?
Oh, no, that was the Shoreham Hotel.
The Shoreham Hotel, a very elegant
place. 800 baths and 200 dirty people running around the hall. Somebody stole my piano, by the way. If you're
Where's
leading
the piano?
It. How do you lose a piano?
Roberto.
Okay, we'll send
it. You'll get it. All right,
there's
it's gone away.
To do that.
In the meantime, shall we carry on?
Let's carry on.
All right, let's carry
on. My crusade is going well.
Say hello to our two players over here, Jeanette
hello,
Jones
player.
And Jerry Renier. Is that right?
Renier. Right. Well, close.
All right, Jeanette, let's get acquainted with you.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm from St. Louis. I just moved out here. I have a 4-year-old daughter, and I'm a waitress at a new place in Century City.
Really? That's mm-hmm. nice. Jeanette, how do you like Los Angeles versus St. Louis?
It's warmer.
It's warmer. Okay.
Definitely warmer.
She's noncommittal. She's being very gracious. Jerry, say it again for me.
Renier.
Renier. Let's all remember that. Jerry Renier.
Renier.
R-E-G-N-I-E-R. All right, Jerry, where are you from?
Well, I'm from Los Angeles. Lived my entire life here. Happily married. 3 children. And I have a most interesting job in that I'm the principal of an elementary school.
Oh, I bet that is a fascinating job.
I started the year with dark hair.
You did. Okay, Jerry, good luck to both of you. Here in the Match Game, you'll each have 3 chances to match as many of the ding-a-lings as you can. The one who's done that most often at the end of the 3rd round will be the winner and go on to challenge our returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Jeanette, you won the toss, so you go first.
I think I'll take B.
B? All right. You may have B if you wish. Here's what it says. When Harry's parachute failed to open,
yes.
Harry screamed, "That's the last time I'll ever buy a parachute from Blaine." Got the idea. Ready up there. Pat, your brain is not functioning today?
Yes, I put my head in there.
Jeanette, when Harry's parachute failed to open, Harry screamed, "That's the last time I'll ever buy a parachute from blank."
Sears?
Sears?
Well, you get your driver's license.
Their prices are lower.
I don't understand it either.
You don't understand that? What we're going after here, well, tell him, Anson. I hope you understood it. Otherwise, I'm going to have to belch in the mouth.
Go for it.
Right.
No. No, well, I did a lot of thinking on this.
You did?
Yeah, and, well, funeral parlor.
What?
Okay.
They'd sell you a faulty parachute, right?
He did not understand it either.
I tried hard, though.
Mark, did you understand?
Well, if I thought a parachute that fell that quickly, I would not buy one from anyone who had moths. However, my real answer is a parachute from Taiwan.
From Taiwan. Now, Mark did not understand it.
He would have understood it if he had his piano, though.
Well, right. Swiss Cheese Factory, I know you'd razz me. So I stuck mother-in-law down. You know, an enemy
from my mother-in-law.
The audience likes it, but that's still not the answer. John, did you understand it? Help me out here, John.
I think I finally did understand it. I think the answer is Kmart.
Of course.
Yeah, attention contestants, huh?
Any discount house or something like that.
Well, Sears was close.
Yeah, Sears was close, but Kmart's a little better. What do you say there, Larry?
Kmart, I'm sorry.
Kmart. Harry, did you understand it?
I understood it.
You did.
Kmart didn't come to mind, but the A&P.
The A&P, okay, that's all right.
That's the first
Kmart.
Words I ever heard.
A&P?
Attention Kmart shoppers.
Really?
The day I was born.
The day you were born?
Yes.
That rang through your ears. All right. Jerry, you ready?
I am.
All right. Lucy said, my husband, the hunter, went on a safari in Central Park. Now we have the head of a blank over the fireplace. Yes, of course.
Lucy said, my husband, the hunter, went on a safari.
Of course, yes. Doing a little artwork, Mark?
Yes.
Oh.
Be right with you. Here we
All right, Jerry. Lucy said, my husband, the hunter, went on a safari to Central Park. Now we have the head of a blank over the fireplace.
Mugger.
Mugger. The implication, of course, being that there are muggers to be found in Central Park. That used to be true. Less true now. Hello, New York. I love New York.
Me too.
Yes.
And muggers in Central Park?
There used to be, but they've really? Got it under control now.
Sure they do.
You are going to get a belt in the mouth before
know,
the show's
know,
over,
I
Anson.
Yeah, I'm getting ready for it. Okay, mugger.
Mugger. Okay, one for Jerry.
Well, first I thought head of a moose, and then I said, no, a Shriner, and then I thought, no, weirdo.
A weirdo,
yeah.
Right. May I ask why you are booing that answer? Do you...
Because they're weirdos, and they
yes.
resent the
implication. Do you have a spokesperson among you who will respond to my question? Yes. Would you stand up and tell me why you
the
were
gentleman
booed?
In the back.
Because we're demolés.
What?
They're demolés.
They're demolés.
Yay, demolés.
What does that mean? Oh, all right. Okay, get them out, would you please? Hello, Pat.
They set fire to car barns. I think that's what a demolé is, yes.
We're looking for the answer, mugger.
Well, they now write suicide notes before they go into Central Park, and I got mugger for
you. You have, all right. That's two for Jerry. My husband, the hunter, went on a safari to Central Park. Now we have the head of a mugger over the fireplace.
Well, as a native New Yorker, I resent these vicious, bitter attack by this native Californian
here.
Who should know better because he is a school teacher on my beautiful city.
Here.
But I did say mugger.
Hey,
I took this to match.
All right, Leonard.
Gene, did you know I used to be a demolé?
You were?
Used to be.
Really?
But now I'm a Frito-Lay.
Now you're a Frito-Lay.
Mugger!
All right, four for Jerry.
I was going to say drunk mugger. To
a
get
drunk
a
ball, mugger.
A drunk mugger, but I just came up with a drunk.
Hey, drunk.
Aww.
All right, that's okay, Mary. There is, it has been known that there's been a drunk or two in Central Park. Jerry, you're ahead at the round one, end of round one, 4-0. And round two coming up right after these messages. Hurry back.
Get ready.
Live limitless.
Here we go, round two. Bing. Jerry, you're ahead. You have to go first.
I'm going to go with B.
You're going with B?
Yes. Don't tell
I
my wife.
George was going with B. Here we go. Say, did you hear that C-3PO got arrested at Kmart?
At Kmart?
No.
At Kmart.
How
yeah.
arrested is he?
Yeah. They caught him in the appliance section trying to make love to a blank. You know who C-3PO is, don't you? No?
No.
Character in Star Wars.
Oh, that's right.
You know,
oh, I'm okay.
You know.
Got it.
Talks funny, no, and it's like...
Right.
One more time. As a matter of fact, you and Mark are the only two who are playing. Thank you. You may assist her since you're not playing this round.
I think he just did. He just did. Okay.
All right, Jerry. Did you hear that C-3PO got arrested at Kmart? They caught him in the appliance section trying to make love to a blank.
To a toaster.
A toaster. Okay. Anything in that line would be okay here, Mark. What came to your mind?
I went to the zoo one time. I saw an octopus trying to make love to a bagpipe, but I put down pencil sharpener.
A pencil sharpener. See?
That took a lot of thinking.
If you understood what was going on in his brain, you wouldn't boo.
They're going to demolay you,
Mark. What's going on here?
This is Leonard's fault. I have to...
I'll accept the blame.
What is it?
Blender.
Hey, blender. No, that's good.
Any appliance.
Well, sure.
The demolays agree.
No, that's okay. That's perfectly all right. Now, Jeanette, let's see if you can do a little catching up here. You got zero so far. Kevin said, I saw an actress last night who was so bad.
How bad was she?
Sorry, if you want to get in the show business, you got to be on your toes here now.
Not quite as bad as that.
You learn to take a cue that you've got to do it. Kevin said, I saw an actress last night who was so bad.
How bad was she?
Sorry, you just blew the job. Just leave your photo, and if we got some walk-on parts, we'll call you sometime. I saw an actress last night who was so bad, in the middle of her show, she got a blanking ovation. That's how bad she was. May I just have a little peek, sir? Right. Okay.
Hey. I saw a movie so bad once that everyone got up and walked out, and it was an in-flight movie to New York.
All right, Jeanette, we're ready for you. Kevin said, I saw an actress last night. It was so bad. In the middle of her show, she got a blanking ovation.
Walking?
Hey, walking, okay. They were walking out on her, is that it? A walking ovation. That's good. I think that's pretty good. They left.
Right.
They left the theater. If you got, there are other good ones, too. You may have one. An unlikely possibility, the way things have been going with you, Anson. But so far, you may...
DeMolay!
Uh-oh, a cover for a bad answer.
Stay with me, gang. Sitting ovation.
That's okay.
Sitting ovation. Sorry.
Anything derogatory like
that. Well, it was
like
a great show except for two things. The sound and the lights were working, but I had sitting ovation.
Sitting ovation is all right. And that's versus a standing ovation, you understand, Pat.
I knew a midget that when he was drowning, his life passed before his knees. I put kneeling ovation.
A kneeling ovation.
Or none.
Okay.
Hey, wait a minute.
How do they decide?
They're all none.
What's good and what's bad?
They're arbitrary. Filled with animal spirits. That's what. They're just trying to get it out of their systems here. In the middle of a show, she got a blanking ovation, John.
Well, I thought the opposite of a standing ovation would be a...
lying down ovation.
Bravo,
all right?
Bravo.
Yeah. There are other good parts. A leaving ovation, a hissing ovation, a booing ovation. Leonard?
Jeanette, your answer was very good. In fact, the first time I ever thought I was getting a standing ovation in Pittsburgh, they were leaving. and because I blanked that out of my mind, I stupidly said...
Sitting ovation. All right. Mary?
I was going for opposites.
You were going for the opposite?
For a real opposite. Not
right.
Even sitting, but lying, you know?
A lying ovation. All right.
Hey, I said the same thing and you booed me!
Right.
I said the same thing!
You're not crazy.
So there's the end of round two. 4-0. Jerry's still ahead. Round three, the final round, right after this.
Hi, I'm...
No.
Ready for round three, the final round. Here we go. Jerry, you're still ahead. You have to go first.
I get to choose. Let's try A this time.
You want A this time?
Bacon. Absolutely.
All right, the two people play, Mark and Mary, the two M's. M&M play. Hey, have you heard about the new adult version of Cinderella? Ooh. I'll tell you, at midnight, she doesn't lose her slipper. Instead, she loses her blank.
I'll drink to that.
Could be rated on this one.
Oh, my.
All right, Mark is ready, Mary's ready. So we come over here to Jerry. Have you heard about the new adult version of Cinderella? At midnight, she doesn't lose her slipper. Instead, she loses her blank.
Her reputation.
Her reputation. Now, wait a minute. Are you... Why are you booing that? What would you have said? You are not of one mind, I can tell that. Mark, he said reputation, and I guess the judges are at this moment, I'm going to stall and give them the chance to think for a moment and see if they're going to match reputation with whatever you're going to say.
Well, since I've won over the hearts of this audience, it doesn't matter what I put up here now, because I'm going to get it anyway.
You are.
But she loses her pumpkin, you remember.
Now, I would do that.
Her That's, pumpkin's yeah. reputation, perhaps.
I must say, Mark, that is indeed a booable answer. All right, Mary.
Are you with me on this?
Sure we are. What is
Virginity.
It?
Virginity!
Virginity.
I'm not afraid to say it.
You did not match that. Okay.
Looks like a no.
It was not a match, Jeanette. That's why I asked the judges to be alert, because I thought perhaps... Jerry, I think. Now, this is your last chance, Jeanette.
I know.
You need 4 to tie and 5 to win. Senator Sam said, he says, things are pretty strange here in Washington. I just called dial a joke and blank answered. I guess it's just for you, Mark. No, it's for everyone. Everyone plays. Are you familiar with Dial-A-Joke and Dial-A-Prayer and all those things and the telephone
yeah.
services? Okay. Anson, we're waiting. Thank you. Things are pretty strange here in Washington, Senator Sam said. I just called Dial-A-Joke and blank answered.
I know I'm going to get this wrong. It's Reagan.
Reagan? Oh, they like that. They like that a lot, as a matter of fact. She's hesitating. She thought it was a wrong answer or an incorrect or not a very good answer, but I thought it was pretty good. What do you say?
The president wouldn't answer.
He wouldn't?
Oh, Congress dang. Would answer.
Congress would answer. All right.
All of them.
Sunday,
here is the supreme
Monday.
Authority on Washington and people in it.
I live in our nation's capital, and there wasn't room on my card for all of the names and possibilities, but I, too, put Congress.
You did put
yes,
Congress.
Yes, I did.
All right, now you got to match everybody else, Jeanette, to stay in the game and achieve a tie. Pat?
My answering machine has fallen in love with Dial-A-Joke, but I helped this lady out here.
Reagan. So now the score is 4-1. John, I just called Dial-A-Joke and Reagan answered, according to Jeanette. What
Gene,
do you
I
say?
Have to disagree with you, though. Before you said this audience is not of one mind. I believe that there's about one mind between all of them.
Right.
Say something that deserved to be booed for a change.
Crowd.
Okay, let's see you boo this. Reagan.
Yeah.
Okay, they're fair. They're fair.
Okay, it's interesting to work with a group of Republicans in the audience. Leonard?
Do you remember when Ronald Reagan was called Ronald Reagan?
I do, and as soon as he became president, everybody started calling him Reagan.
Jeanette, did you happen to give me a standing ovation in St. Louis last winter in a play that I did there at the Loretto Hilton? Did you, Jeanette?
Oh, I certainly did. I
Tell
really
the truth,
did.
Jeanette.
The truth. I'd give you a standing ovation anytime.
But you weren't in the theater. In spite of that, Jeanette.
She wants to see your answer now. Look.
President.
All right. 4-3. Mary, she got to match you to test.
I can't believe you would think that's a rotten answer. That's a fabulous answer.
Aha! So,
come back and tie.
All right, okay. We clearly have a tie here. That means we have to go to a tiebreaker and come to a resolution of which of these two will be the winner. Here are the two, here is the tie-breaking question. I will read it to you. Don't say anything until I ask you to. Blank post. Blank post, P-O-S-T. Now, in front of you, but out of sight of our stars, are four good answers to this question. Your seats were determined by lot, and the rule is, Jerry, You go first. You may choose one of these answers by number only. Don't say any words. Just tell me whether you want number 1, 2, 3, or 4.
I'll take number 1.
You'll take number 1? All right, I will give that to you. And now, Jeanette, you tell me what you think is the best answer of the remaining ones.
I'll take number 3.
You'll take number 3. All right, I will give that to you. Now I'm going to go over here and canvass our stars for verbal responses. And as soon as you hear the answer you have, you will call it out and let me know. All right? Now, Anson, you'll be up first. How do you fill in that blank? Blank post.
Oh, post. I thought you said host. It's a whole new beginning here. Post.
Yes.
Or ending.
Our ending. Emily.
Emily Post. And we have a winner. Right. Jerry has that answer.
Emily.
She's
here somewhere.
All right, come on down. Over here, Jerry, right next to me, and I'll get to you in a moment or so. We're going to say goodbye to Jeanette Jones.
Thank you.
Going to send some gifts your way. Many thanks for being on the Match Game. Hey, over here. Now. We are bringing the rest of the set in. We're going to switch over to Hollywood Squares in a moment or so. Three more celebrities will make an entrance here. John and I will change places. He's going to host Hollywood Squares. We've got lots more excitement coming up here. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive a white sewing machine with 10 built-in utility and stretch stitches on one color-coded dial, lightweight with built-in handle for easy portability, furnished by White Sewing Machine. It's time for more of The Match Game. Hollywood Square, Power, with Sybil Danning. Bill Proctor. And taking over, the star of the Hollywood Square, John Bowman.
Well, I'm going to enter with some dignity. Okay, we're going to be right back. Come back if you dare.
Thank you.
And now, John Bowman and the Hollywood Square.
Finally, they stop cooing.
Okay, this is Jerry Renier. He is an elementary school principal who founded Elementary to make his way through the Match Game. Now he's ready to move on to Hollywood Squares. We also have to say hello to three brand new celebrities. They are Phil Proctor,
hi,
Sybil Danning, and Jenny Lee Harrison. And I'm tempted to ask, what is wrong with this picture? Phil.
Yes, yes, John. I thought.
Yeah, there seems to be a fish in your square.
Well, Monsieur Renier, Monsieur Renier will understand this. I was with my daughter, Kristen, at a birthday party, and they insisted that all the parents wear funny balloons so that we could be identified in the playground. And they said it'd be easy enough for a child to remove, but is there a child in the audience? Please, I'd prefer. I can't get it off, John. I'm sorry.
One of the
I hope this doesn't affect my credibility with the players today. I'll do my best to help.
Was that your daughter that dropped you off here?
Yes.
I saw her.
Okay, well, I guess there's only one way out of this, Jerry. Let's go play Hollywood Squares. Here we go.
I'd rather make it with a piece.
Would you? And before we begin our action-packed game, here's a lady who has had an action-packed week. Her name is Victoria Narbutis. Yesterday, she and I collaborated. We rented a car together, and she earned $30,000, the maximum you can win on our show in one day. She is our defending champion. She has a total altogether of 34,225 smackaroos. You're doing okay. Not too bad. Tell us a little bit about yourself for these people who may be here for the first time.
I'm a newlywed as of about 3 weeks, and I'm studying to be a CPA, and I do a lot of volunteer work for many animal organizations.
Is your husband a little bit more happily married now that you've earned $34,000?
Yeah, well, he loves me just the same.
Good. Attaboy. Okay, well, you got another day to play Hollywood Squares, and we're going to play this game until you hear the time's up bell. Whoever's ahead at that point is our winner and goes out to play Supermatch for up to $30,000, and you know it's possible to win that. First game is worth $100 plus 25 smackers for every square that these are captured. Our champion, of course, gets to start. That is you, Victoria.
Can you repeat that?
People know this. Yeah.
That
is you, Victoria. Take a good look at these ding-dongs and pick a star.
Mark, please.
Mark!
At your service.
Mark Russell from Real People, among other places. When Ronald Reagan was a teenager, he was very close to Muggs Cleaver. Was that his football coach, his girlfriend, or his dog?
It was a fellow, Muggs Cleaver, who he has a sub-cabinet position now. They were buddies at Eureka College in Iowa, where the president was on the radio, I forget the call letters, he did sports. But anyway, this was, he's a crony, an old friend, and he's Assistant Secretary of Transportation now.
Is that his football coach, his girlfriend, or his dog? Oh, he said Assistant Secretary of Transportation, so it's probably his dog, right?
Yeah.
No, those are your only three choices now, Mark.
Yeah, give me the
this
three.
Is like multiple choice. Yeah. His football coach, his girlfriend, or his dog. I promise you it's one
it
of those.
It was his coach. I said it was his coach. I meant to say
oh,
it was his coach.
Okay.
And he's now a sub-cabinet member.
Victoria, he says it was his football coach. Agree or disagree for the first square?
I agree.
It was his girlfriend. You should have disagreed. I'm sorry if I missed it if you said coach. I did miss that completely. It was his girlfriend.
It was his
Muggs's real name was, in fact, Margaret Cleaver.
I remember that. Yes.
Yes, not related to Beaver Cleaver. Jerry, pick a star.
Mary.
Mary Page Keller from Another World, as are many of our celebrities.
Yeah.
But you're on the show. Mary, when are your breasts larger? During the summer or during the winter?
Show and tell, Mary.
I know this answer. Don't ask me how. During the summer. Obviously, you've just got a lot more moistness and they're plump, and that's where a lot of water is stored. Come on, I'm trying
or
to be scientific.
Perhaps.
Really? No, really. It's during the summer.
Okay, Jerry, she says your breasts are larger during the summer. Agree or disagree?
I will disagree.
During the summer, it is. You should have agreed with Mary. She knows.
Even close.
Your opponent gets that square, Jerry. Okay, that evens it up. An X to an O. Victoria, you are playing X. Pick a star for me.
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn. Gene.
I'm ready.
A question for you. This city has more neon signs than any other city in the world. Is it Las Vegas, New York, or Tokyo?
Summertime is my favorite season of the year. Let's see, I was in Tokyo only briefly. I was in Las Vegas a couple of days ago. More neon. Obviously, I mean, Las Vegas is an incredible place. I mean, there's more neon there than probably in all of the rest of the cities in the world put together. I don't think there's any contest here.
Agree or disagree that Las Vegas has more neon signs than any other city, Victoria?
I agree.
Tokyo has more neon signs than any other city. You should have disagreed. Your opponent gets that square. Probably it's just much larger in area, among other things.
Okay, certainly.
Than Las Vegas. Okay, we're going to be back to complete an exciting first game right after these messages, and you come back to it.
Stay tuned for more of The Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour.
One car accident.
Back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
Okay, 50 for Jerry Renier and 25 so far for our Renier champion, Victoria Narbutas. It's your move, Jerry. You got two O's up there on the board. Where would you like to place another one?
With Jenna Lee to win.
Well,
Jenna Lee Harrison, this could win the first game. Which contains more salt, Jenny Lee? A drop of seawater or an average human teardrop?
Oh, goodness. Which contains more salt, seawater or a teardrop?
Right.
Seawater. Right?
For the game,
because
Jerry.
Seawater, because that's when they take the seawater and that's where they get all the salt from, yeah?
She saw Gandhi.
Don't look at me. For the
I
game,
saw
Jerry.
Gandhi.
Agree or disagree? She says seawater.
A
drop of seawater contains more salt than the average human teardrop.
I will disagree.
A drop of seawater contains more salt. You should have agreed. Your opponent gets the square and stays in the game. New life.
That's right. That was the inspiration for the song Cry Me a River. Do you remember that?
Victoria, do you feel inspired
too, right
now? Pick a star.
Yeah. Pat, to win, please.
Pat McCormick, and this will win you the game. Pat, according to the Amy Vanderbilt Complete Book of Etiquette, this is always the best gift for a nun. Is it cash or a bottle of wine?
Bottle of wine. Dated enough, you ought to know.
I just was looking in that book of etiquette. You're not supposed to enter a restaurant on horseback, it said in there. I think because of the wine in the church sacramental things and the fact that they wouldn't have a chance to use cash much, that a bottle of wine would be more appropriate than cash.
For the game, agree or disagree that a bottle of wine is a better gift than cash for a nun?
I disagree.
Cash is the best gift for a nun. You're right to disagree. You're an excellent player. You win the game. That is good play. You went to disagree. You got three X's in a row. You won $100. That gives you $175 so far. 50 for you, Jerry. You're not behind by very much. We're going to clear the board right now. Move on to the next game. And this one is worth 200 smackaroos. And Jerry, you get to start it. Pick a star.
Let's start with Phil.
Thank you. Proctor. Phil, according to the Census Bureau, what did we bring more of into this country last year? Immigrants or anchovies?
I like anchovies. I like to hold the pizza and just get anchovies. But most people don't. And yet there are... I'm trying to be logical. I've made such a fool of myself before. I would say that the answer would have to be immigrants. Well, it wouldn't have to be, but I'm going to say it is immigrants.
Agree or disagree, Jerry, for the first square. More immigrants than anchovies.
I will disagree.
We brought more anchovies into this country last year than we did immigrants.
I should have listened.
Yes, you get the square. That is hard to believe. What has happened to our country, Victoria? What's happened
to
our
country? My whole family swam into this country.
Pick a square.
Mark, please.
Mark Russell. Who has bigger front teeth? An adult beaver or Mary Tyler Moore?
I remember Jimmy Carter's resembled chiclets at one time when we first...
He could eat corn on the cob from the back.
That is true. So, Pat. Well, a beaver, I mean, my goodness. A beaver. Sure.
He says a beaver has bigger front teeth than Mary Tyler Moore. Agree or disagree, Victoria?
I agree.
A beaver it is. You're perfectly right to agree. You get the square. A beaver's teeth are an inch to an inch and a half. Some teeth. Okay, some teeth. We have to complete it after the... Victoria, 75 so far for Jerry. We got Nixon and O up there, and Jerry, you are playing O. Pick a star.
Mary again.
Jerry's got a crush.
Mary Page Keller. Don't blame him. Can you stain stainless steel, or is stainless steel really stainless?
That was good.
Thank you.
Sounds like a rude.
Did you understand what I said?
Oh, yes, I did.
Oh,
yes. Stain stainless steel. Mm-hmm. Yes, you can stain stainless steel. Absolutely.
Agree or disagree, Jerry?
I hate to say it, but I will disagree.
You can stain stainless steel. You should have agreed with Mary Page Decker. Your opponent gets
with
that
eggs.
Square. Okay.
With my breath.
Reasoning doesn't count here, Gene. Just the right answer. Victoria, pick a star. You're playing X.
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn.
All right.
Gene.
Gene is ready.
Yes, Gene. You see a female orangutan playing all by herself. Does this mean she's in the mood for love or she wants to be left alone?
What is she doing?
What kind of game is she playing? Reminds me, I got to send my alimony check in.
What's that?
Could be Hollywood Squares.
Yes. This female orangutan is just hanging around... swinging from tree to tree and branch to branch and scratching and smiling and having a wonderful time. And you want to know if she's...
in the mood for love or she wants to be left alone.
Well, I say any kind of... there certainly is some kinship between those animals and these animals.
Very little difference, I might add.
That's right.
What's
it would seem to me that when a woman... craves attention, she does make some sort of demonstration. So I would say the same thing would apply to an orangutan.
He says she's in the mood for love. Agree or disagree, Victoria?
I agree.
She is in the mood for love. You're right.
You agree, and you get the square. Two X's up there, actually three.
I saw me coming out of the motel last night.
Jerry, pick a star for me.
Leonard DeBlock.
Jerry. Right. Jerry,
you missed this
think,
one?
Excuse me, I just want to ask the high school principal a question. Do you think that nun would take a check?
Fifth Amendment.
Okay, you missed this one. Victoria will take the game. Jerry. Leonard, you're drinking a glass of wine, and you give your four-year-old daughter a sip.
I'm saying, pronounce the word.
You're drinking a glass of wine, Leonard.
Yes.
And you give your four-year-old daughter a sip.
Yes.
According to Parents Magazine, is that a bad thing to do, or is it totally harmless?
They prefer you to give them a case. Quiets the child.
Yes, with a check.
Particularly around nursery time. But no more toilet training in the kitchen.
No. That was yesterday's show.
I still haven't got over that.
My four-year-old daughter sent the wine back.
I can't get a meal down.
Well, let's get over
this. I would say without equivocation, a little sip of wine. I mean, France, there wouldn't be. They all drink. A little sip of wine is a wonderful, soothing, calming, delightful thing.
They make it already.
It's totally,
it's called Chateau Gerber's. I've seen it in.
So Jerry Leonard says that it's totally harmless to give your four-year-old daughter a sip of wine. Agree or disagree to block?
I would agree.
It is a bad thing to do. According to Parents Magazine, you should have disagreed. Your opponent gets a square and wins another game.
I don't agree with you.
She's bouncing now. And she's really bouncing because the bell means the time is up with $475. Once again. This is five. Who's got four? Okay. Congratulations, you've done well. I'm sure you know by this time that your next move is to troop yourself right over there, join Gene Rayburn, get set for another shot at the big money. Jerry, we do have to say goodbye to you. Obviously, she's an excellent player. You know,
yes.
She's got a good track record. You weren't so bad yourself, and you're all leaving here with $75. And, of course, our thanks for playing Match Game Hollywood Squares.
Thank you.
And my wife's an elementary school principal. We'll talk later. Okay, and right now, here's someone who's got to talk, Gene Rayburn.
Okay, John, here we are congratulating Victoria one more time. We'll be back with her and our nine celebrities and a chance for her to win another big pile of money after this.
Some people say...
order now.
Now, here to play the super match is Gene Rayburn.
Okay, Gene, well, thank you. All right, Victoria, here we go with a super match where you can win up to $30,000. Let's begin. We polled a recent studio audience and write down your best response to this. Blank white. $1,000 for the top answer, $500 for the second most popular, and $250 for the third. Any three of the six stars of the nine stars can offer some assistance. Whom do you call on first?
Only six of us are really stars.
John, please.
Snow.
All right, Snow White is one.
Anson, please.
Betty White.
Yay, Betty White. Yay, Betty White.
Jenna Lee.
Me? Jenny Lee.
Jenny Lee White? That's interesting.
I was thinking black and white.
Well, all right. You want to say that? That's fine. So you have black and white, Betty White, and Snow White. Now you must make a decision. Choose one of those or give us one of your own.
Betty, please.
You want Betty? We all want Betty. But it's... he's playing hard to get. All right, we love you, Betty. Let's see if Betty White is under the $250 response. It is indeed. $250. All right, let's take a look at the $500 answer.
Yeah.
Black and white. There's Jenny Lee's answer. And now, let's slide the big one, Greg. Yeah. Snow White it is. John gave you that one. Now, Victoria, you got $250. Time now to play the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing. And each star, remember, has a number in front, a 10, a 20, or a 30. After you choose a star, that star will reveal that number and see how much we're going to multiply your $250 by. Time now to make a pick.
Okay, John, please.
All right, John, grab the tab and give it a yank. And let's see if you've got the big 3-0 again for 2 days in a row. 10 it is. So that means you are playing for $2,500. All right. That will put you well over $35,000 if you collect that additional amount. Here we go. Good luck to you. This is it. Bonnie blank. B-O-N-N-I-E blank. Bonnie blank.
Me change now.
Anything you say is okay with us. All right, now, Victoria, John is ready. For $2,500, how would you fill in that blank to match him?
Bonnie and Clyde.
All right, let's turn around and find out what John has. This is Bonnie and Clyde, John.
Me shouldn't all have changed.
You had Bonnie and Clyde?
Me had Bonnie and Clyde right here. Want to see?
Yeah.
Me no have it under here.
What do you have there?
Because she went television with Betty White. And I faked myself out, so I said Bonnie Franklin.
All right.
It was just because she went television.
That was another one of the possibilities.
They're here both it is. Good. See it?
But listen, she's not doing badly, is she? She has $34,950. Wowee. All right, we'll be back with her and our stars in a moment or so right after this.
Mom. About the motion, baby.
Okay, here we go. Let's find out which of the stars had the big 3-0. Stars, would you grab the tabs and give it a pull right
Poulet
now?
Fou.
Who had it?
Jenna Lee
had it for the big 3-0.
Well, not today, dear.
Maybe tomorrow. All right, she'll be
yesterday,
back here tomorrow.
Certainly.
Gene Raven inviting you to join us tomorrow.
And John Bauman saying so long for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. See you then.
A member of our studio audience will receive Hitachi's 13-inch diagonal table model color TV, 100% solid state, low power consumption, special signal tracker system, memory fine-tuning 70-position UHF tuner furnished by Hitachi. This is Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. A Mark Goodson Television Production.